everybody, and welcome inside the dome here at the Whitby Soccer Center for some Week 1 Ontario action. I'm your man on the call, Sean McLeod, as the 4-8-4 Darby FC side will take on the 6-8-1 Windsor City FC. Your starting lineups for today for the visiting Windsor City FC: Dante Carrero, Mark David Siegel, Riley Drukalik, Bastian Aguilera, Andre Aminoff, Jose Pabon, Jonathan Agapito, Owen Antoniuk, Kaylin Loibel, Marcos Quiroga, and Braden Stefanovic. Your starting lineup for the home Derby FC is Matt Zakos in net, Jaden Vilfort, Jaden Doyle, Caleb Pierce, Matthew Perovic, Kashif Collins, Dylan Campbell, Colin Riley, Julian Gonzalez, Tyler Sukowski, and Carlos Edick in the midfield. Both of these teams falling just below the line in terms of the separation of the league next season. And when I say just below the line, it is ever so slightly. Currently, Derby sitting in 14th. There's 12 slots. And currently in the 12th slot is Hamilton United. Derby currently 10 points behind Hamilton United, so it's going to be a bit of a trek to catch up as this season shortens out, including this game. This will be the fourth last game on the schedule for Derby FC, so you can do the math there. There is certainly some help required to reach that goalpost for Derby. And was a good start, as that goes out of bounds, and it was a good start last week as Derby picked up a massive 5-0 win over Unionville Milliken after going three games with ties on the score sheet. They pick up a point, but certainly there's been a few games this season where you want to pick up all three as possession's lost in the midfield. Windsor City on the attack now. Ball comes out to Stefanovic. Quiroga. Lobel, and he'll cycle it back. Windsor City FC, like I said, they're also below the belt in terms of the separation of the league next year. And I believe, I don't have it directly in front of me at the moment, and kicking myself for not writing it down, but I believe they're just behind Derby in that regard, despite having the positive record. Adding the 2 points from, or adding the two seasons together in terms of points is how you will calculate that at the end of the season. And there has been a handful of teams that have already secured their spot. Cash. And chips it a bit too high and will head over to the other side, and that easily picked up. Aminoff gets back. Looking for Pabon on the run. Whistle called. Will be going the other way for Derby. So among the teams that have already clinched their spot in the Premier, Vaughan, the Blue Devils, Guelph, Simcoe, Alliance, and North Toronto, and still remaining on the schedule for Derby, will be Simcoe as they visit here at the last home game of the season. Cash. And the ball is just a bit behind him. Quiroga puts the burners on to try and get to it. Zakos will clear it. Aminoff heads it forward. Doyle tied up a bit out wide. And a yellow card's going to be given. So first yellow card of the afternoon. Oh. points here today would be massive for Darby. They're going to look to strike first here off this set piece. A bit wide, and they'll move it back ever so slightly. But there is some aerial threats here on Darby. Gonzalez, Sikorsky can get up there. Kashif, the leading scorer for the squad. Set in place. And the kick is well over top. Can Sikorsky get there to keep it in? Looks like he does. He'll be pushed out for a throw-in. Deflected off Collins, because that will be a goal kick for Dante Carraro. But in terms of the magic needed to clinch that spot, and it'll likely come down to the wire if they're going to make a run at it here for Derby to clinch that final spot in the Premiership. As Gonzalez heads it forward, can they get it out? And it stays with Windsor City. But to clinch that final spot in the Premiership, it's going to take almost a nearly flawless victory from here on out, maybe some help from a couple teams above them. But if they can get to that final game in position, cross was in and just a bit in front of Sikorsky. If they can get to that final game against BBV International Academy Waterloo, certainly a positive position for them. And that'll be pushed back to Riley. That'll roll out for a goal kick for Zinkos. There's a few people on this Windsor City FC side that Darby's going to have to keep an eye on today. Chief among them might be Braden Stefanovic, who we've already seen him a bit on ball, although Darby has done well to keep on the attack for the most part throughout the first 8 minutes or so of this game. Stefanovic, coming in with 3 goals on the season, has had some time representing Canada in the U17 squad, a real talent out wide. Of course, Darby looking to build on that massive 5-0 victory over Unionville Milliken. And the attendance here today is just wonderful. Kick is in, and Gonzalez and Carraro get into a bit of a collision. Doyle is going to come back to Perovic. Riley. And that's out for a throw-in off the foot of Andrei Aminov. Doyle moves it forward, looking to keep it in, and that will be a goal kick. Bond gets on top of it. Vilfort into the 18-yard line and bounced off of the shin of Colin Riley. This will be the first corner kick of the afternoon for Windsor City, and it will be Owen Antoniuk heading out to take it. Low kick, headed away by Doyle. Lobel and Darby finally gets it on the foot. Grovic moves it out to Gonzalez. Windsor City now looking to build their attack. And Aminoff trying to find Jose Pabon. He is offside. Darby will play it quickly. As they look to manipulate this defense, find a way in. And almost there for Sikorski. We'll be back to Pierce. Perovic. Campbell. Edick. And Suko takes a bump. And there's... looked like there was a booking coming, and flag stays in the pocket for now. Shoulder to shoulder contact, and Suko headed to the ground in a heap. He's up and walking it off. That's good to see. Referee's gonna hand out a few admonishments. It'll be a free kick, no booking. And Doyle lining up for the free kick. This one is in a bit more of a dangerous position than the last one. About 21 yards out. Doyle sends it low. And you can see the thought process there. Darby was just a bit behind the ball. So this would be a throw-in coming for Windsor City. 13 minutes here into the first half, and it's been a good first half for Darby. Down out of bounds is Edick. So this would be not a throw-in, but it would be a free kick from the spot just to the right of the out-of-bounds line. And a good clear in, headed to the net off of the head of Cash Collins. Carrero scoops it up. For it, lets it roll to Zakos. Gonzalez. So Windsor played out the back. Stefanovic keeps possession of it. That was a nice sliding tackle there for Guilford as well. So good job to keep possession. Zekos. He'll have Kierga, closing in on him quickly. Pierce. Looking to kickstart the offense for Darby. Sikorski. Nice. Chipped forward, and it's just a bit high. Sikorski's really gotten involved here on the right side of the attack over the past few games. I mentioned it a few times, but started the season injured and worked his way back slowly, and that was an intentional thing from Darby to do so. But now that he's back, he's in the lineup. He got a assist in the last game with Kashif Collins on the receiving end of the goal. And you can see he's just a real solid presence defensively, and he can get up on the attack as well. Stefanovic passes it back to Aminoff. Doyle. And this will be a throw-in for Darby. To Gonzalez. Seiko swaying his options, and Windsor thought about bringing the press up as well. Ball heads out. They're starting to find a bit of structure in their attack. We're on the back foot for the first 15 minutes or so, 13, 15 minutes. They've had their chances here and there. Aminoff pushes it forward. Antonia out to Stefanovic on the wing. Into the box! Off woodwork. Pabon was there, took the shot well. And just a bit behind Kashif Collins. And that was, for either side, the first significant chance of the afternoon. Launches it. Riley. And in that brief moment, you can see how Stefanovic is really one of the players that you need to be mindful of if you're Darby. Real dynamic player, there's a lot of skill to him. He can get on the board scoring, but out on the wing there has some great passing ability as well. Some athleticism to him. Edick. Pierce. Chips it wide. And the shot goes high. A tough angle shot, to be fair. Hopeful. But certainly in that position, it's you take the shot or you lose possession. ball goes high. It doesn't go very far. Still, it will end up at the feet of Windsor City FC. Kurovic wins it back for Darby. Send it out wide. Agapito looking for Pavon. Yeah, throw in for Darby. Through the first 20 minutes or so, it really feels like Darby just has to pay attention to this counterattack. Darby's getting their possession stats right now. Doing well in that regard. But when Windsor can spring the counter and get moving quickly, that's where they've looked the most dangerous so far. Stefanovic gets it and stays onside. Antoniuk. Aminoff. Ball heads into the box. No problem for Zaykos. Bit of a tough shot. Honestly, not even fully convinced it was a shot. Just a foot got on it and pushed it through. Zaykos. And Windsor's done well to win these long balls that are intended for Kashif Collins as well. Ferrero sends this one high. He's got some booming kicks on him. Antonia taken down. That'll be a card coming. It'll be a yellow card given to, I believe, Colin Riley. So a free kick coming for Windsor City FC. It looks like this would be Owen Antoniuk. Aminoff getting some instruction from his head coach. Good chance to do so. Antonia straight into the wall. And the ball hit the referee, so we'll come back to that spot. Colin Riley confirmed as the first recipient of the yellow card. Windsor a bit dismayed, arguing that they were gaining possession of the ball prior to the referee being hit by it. Nonetheless, Darby will quickly give it back to them. Lobel back to Carrero. Jose Pabon, and that'll be out. Set piece is starting to pile up for Windsor City. It looks like this will go back to Owen Antonio as he heads out for the corner kick. Doyle. He gets taken down. Nothing to card there, but right in front of this packed house here in Whitby. Stefanovic. And the whistle called will end that in its tracks. Gonzalez. Back to Riley. Aminoff. And Vilfort heads it forward. Perovic. Out to Doyle. Ash was looking to catch up to it, and Carrero was right on top of it. Doyle. Sends it wide, nobody's there. And that will head out into the crowd. Perovic, take it down. Whistle would be called, and that's a fairly easy one for the ref. Right in front of him, he's going to give some words of advice. Zekos. And we'll do this again as the whistle will bring it back for a retry at it. Saying that Zekos was too far forward. I'm not entirely sure what that whistle was for, but I believe that's what it was for. Perovic to Pierce. Edek. Antoniuk. And this is where you really have to keep an eye on that man right there, and what a sliding tackle from Jaden Vilfort. Keeps it off the foot of Braden Stefanovic. Into 30 minutes elapsed here in the first half of this afternoon's game. And pretty evenly matched. The Darby had a heavy advantage in possession stats. And the ball was right there for Dylan Campbell. Well defended. Headed out for a throw-in. Vilfort to Edek. Sagal moves it forward into the 18-yard line. Pabon, and the ball gets punched away off the ground. Zakos keeps this nil-nil. That's about as clutch as you get in terms of save. And once again, another great opportunity for Windsor City FC when the counterattack gets rolling. Grovic. Sikorski. It's pushed out wide to Agapito. Edek. He gets it back, and Sikorski now, he'll stay on. Brings it into the 18-yard line. He's taken down. That's going to be a penalty. And you could probably hear Coach Herman Kingu. He's just yelling at Tyler. Bring it into the box. Bring it into the box as he brought it in. I thought that was going to be a chip pass. Looking for Dylan Campbell, who is right in front of the net. And sure enough, as Suko brings it in, a stray foot gets in the way. And this is going to be Kashif Collins on the spot, the leading goal scorer for Derby on the season. And what a season Cash has had, the veteran leadership. And easily done, well taken on the board. Darby's up 1-0. Kashif Collins, that's 10 for number 10 on the season. His 10th goal. And every goal from here on out, every save, it just means so much when you're in the position that Darby is in on the table to clinch your spot. They're right on the bubble. Like I said, they're about just under 10 points. It's something ridiculous, like 9.86. It's doable, certainly doable, with four games remaining. If you win them all and Hamilton trips up, there's a chance. But you need things to go your way, and certainly that is the way that you want to start this game. 32 minutes in. And then a game where a lot of the best chances have gone towards Windsor City so far. As Quiroga was the intended recipient of the pass. Antonia. Stefanovic keeps it in, and that's out. Windsor throw it. So Aguilera get things started as Windsor looks to build up their attack. That's kicked out by Jaden Doyle out into the stands. And you can hear the Whitby FC U12 girls here in attendance coming off an incredible performance in the USA Cup. One of just two Whitby teams to take home that prestigious title. They got a rousing reception here at the beginning of the game. Suko gets taken down. I'm not sure if he got taken down or if Suko did the taking down. The referee will assess that Suko did the taking down. So Suko having a laugh about it as he gets back on defense and Stefanovic unable to keep it in. Pierce heads it to Suko. Dylan Campbell, he'll have to do some work to get to the ball, and Carrera! Dante Carrero. That was almost disastrous with Dylan Campbell closing in. But best case scenario will be a goal kick for Windsor City. Vilfort. Ticking into 37 minutes. So the end of the first half not far away, and possession gifted as Quiroga unable to catch up to the ball. Zekos finds Collins and it's picked up quickly by Lobel in return. Zekos, what a save. And it was a long range shot, just about 25 yards or so out. But it was a bit of a howler, tough to keep your hands on top of it. Zekos kind of blocked it more than saved it. And when you block it, you still have to do some work on the back end of that play. And that shot went high. Antoniuk. Suko breaks it up. Pierce gives it away. Stefanovic matched up with Suko. Antonia. And that will be a corner kick coming for Windsor City. And a bit of an unfortunate moment there for Darby. Antonia once again will be lining up for the set piece. Low and in. Quiroga almost there to get it in his head and just deflected at a sharp angle. I believe it was off of a Darby defender's shoulder. Perovic. Quiroga get tied up. A positive first half here for Darby. A lot of good things to take away and clearly some things to work on when you go into halftime in regards of kind of balancing out this counterattack from Windsor City, which has not yet gotten on the board, but that does not mean that there hasn't been chances for them. And quality chances at that. Lobo trying to find Stefanovic. Edic looks to find Doyle, didn't get enough on it, and probably some contact on the pass, nothing to call. Just some good defending. And out into the crowd. Drop ball for Windsor and give him back in kind. Seikos will pick it up, and you can hear the instructions from the Darby bench. They're looking to get the ball out a bit faster and get moving. Perovic to Doyle. Doyle shut down quickly there by Sagal. In comes Quiroga for some pressure. Perovic into the box looking for Dylan Campbell. And headed away by Aminoff. Clears it out. Quiroga puts his head down and just outraced by Julian Gonzalez. And it looks like we're going to have 2 minutes of added time tacked on at the end of the 45 here. Edic to Cash. Windsor was looking for a call. Cash makes his way through. He'll pick up the call, and that's going to be a free kick in an advantageous spot. And just outside of the 18-yard box will be this free kick from the looks of things. Yeah, roughly 20 yards out, didn't see a card go up. Darby looks to take a 2-0 lead into halftime, which the way this game is going would be massive. And they do it! 2-0! What a strike! What a great way to head into the halftime mark. If you are Darby, this has been a close game. To go in up 2-0. And Colin Riley, I mean, that's the highlight of the season for him. He's played well here. And there you have it, the 2 minutes of added time officially. And we are into that added time as we speak. Aminoff. We'll send it back to Aguilera. Presses in from Dillon, and Aminoff is just suffocated. Random ball popped over on the Darby bench. A loud noise, and everybody looked down the bench. So I guess they won't be using that as a game ball anytime soon. Riley, and he'll play it back to Zakos. Headed into half, Darby's up 2-0 with a penalty kick from Cashin Collins and a set piece for the ages. Put it on the highlight reel, Colin Riley. We'll be back here in about 10 minutes. Hello, everybody, and welcome back here for the second half of action inside the dome here in Whitby for some League One and very important League One Ontario game. And that, as Darby looks to close the gap and pick up the last spot for promotion next year. And right now, currently in the driver's seat is Darby FC, as they're taking on Windsor City FC. Windsor City making a substitution at halftime, bringing on Thomas and taking off Loeble in the midfield. And Darby on the front foot for most of that first half. Had a few chances given up to Windsor off of some deft counterattack movements, but still it was a penalty kick from Cashin Collins at 32 minutes that broke this game open. And then a set piece that resulted in a beautiful strike from Colin Riley at about the 40th moment or so. Windsor now, they have some room, and once again you have to pay attention to this man, Braden Stefanovic. He cuts in and poked out from Gonzalez. Antonio, he tries to turn a corner and doesn't find any room. So Owen Antonio, he'll line up for the corner. He's taken all of the set pieces so far for Windsor City FC. Had a close one earlier, the last corner before half. And that was well taken. And also a well-timed run by Thomas, who just checked into the game. And that's about as close as you get without getting on target. But it had some velocity on it too. If that had made its way anywhere near the net, that probably would have been a scorcher of a goal. Campbell. Pierce. Zizekuko. skied up. Collins is there for it. Gonzalez. No, well struck. On target. And Carrero able to take it into his hands. I always find it interesting when you don't see it too often, but sometimes Gonzalez will move up into the attack as the center back. I mean, you'll see him in there as sort of a target man on set pieces in different formations, but he gets some room. He's not afraid to move it up and take those booming long-range kicks. He's a young fella, too. Getting ready for his freshman season with the Ontario Tech Ridgebacks. As a head coach of the U21 reserves here, and this is going to be a corner kick coming for Darby as well, and I know coach is very happy to have Julian on board. He's played well here for Darby. So Doyle will be taking this for Darby. Ref is just making sure that there's no funny business going on. Stefanovic will ride that out, and this will be a goal kick. So nothing comes with the corner kick from Darby. Its way through to Agapito that will head out for a Darby throw in. No, it is given to Windsor. Edick trying to find Pierce. It'll be picked up by Aminoff. Deflected off of the foot of Jaden Vilfort. So out for a Windsor City throw-in. And you can feel a bit of momentum starting to build on the side of Windsor City as they begin to find a bit more in terms of possessions percentage here in this half. No call. Going the other way with it will be Pierce and a very late whistle. Going to be a booking. It doesn't. And it looks like it will be given to number five. That is Bastian Aguilera, the captain for Windsor City FC. So just as I talk about the momentum starting to flow in the opposite direction, a yellow card given out. Zekos. This will find its way into the box and off of the head of Thomas. Vilfort's there for it, as well as Agapito. And Agapito will be there for to throw it. Whistle going the other way. And you can feel the urgency that Windsor is starting to play with. And anytime there starts to be a little bit of positive movement over the past few possessions, it's been cut out by referee Whistle. Guerrero plays it out wide. Agapito's there and boots it out of bounds. And he's going to be... He's going to be upset with that, as Agapito had tons of room to work with on the sideline. Thomas. Stefanovic. Antoniuk tries to find his way into the 18-yard line, and Gonzalez stands him up, and man, as a former defender, I can say, when you really just stonewall somebody, there's no feeling like it. I'm sure scoring a goal feels great. There's just something about it, and you can see Gonzalez, he was feeling it there. So corner kick coming here for Windsor. Kicks in, they're calling for a handball. And no call, and an interesting result there, as Windsor was arguing for a handball, and I mean, that was a good like 42 yards out, and that's not a well-taken kick at all. Goes high, wide, and that'll be a goal kick, but comes in the kind of upset nature there. This will come back. Cash, can he get there for it? It's going to bounce its way to Segal, who clears it. Sikorski somehow keeps that in. He'll flip the field to Doyle, who has a lot of room and one defender to beat. He does, gets the shot on, and Dylan Campbell was almost there for it. Nice little attacking moment for Darby there, who have gotten, so far, both of their goals off of set pieces. And that's about as close as they've come from just a goal through actual buildup. Stefanovic pushes it forward to Pabon and hits the side of the net. We're going to see a substitution readying up for Darby.
Trader, you're good. Trader,
go ahead. As we have a player down for Darby currently, Jaden Doyle. And Jaden Doyle's up, walking off the field. Always love that. And it appears like Michael DiRenzo his place, and he is. So first substitute of the game for Darby FC. And Doyle's played well. And we'll see Suko flip sides. Stefanovic on. And a clutch foot on the ball from Jaden Vilfort. Stops that in its tracks. And as I was saying, Suko will flip sides for Darby. Pierce. Ships it to Suko. And that'll be out for a throw-in. Kashif. And the deflected ball, but I believe that was deflected off of Cash. There's a secondary bounce. Flag will go up, going the other way with it is Windsor. So Carrero will push everyone forward. Dorenzo. And it's going to be Edick. Vilfort tries to force it through. It'll end up in possession of Windsor. The foot of Cashew Collins. Pierce. Potentially a miscommunication for Darby as the ball rolls through to Carrero. Stefanovic pushes it forward. Tied up with Suko. Stefanovic keeps possession. It gets deflected and into the hands of Zenko. Balance takes that contact from Suko and just runs through it. Pierce to Edick. Campbell gets the shot on straight at Carrero. Segel. Stefanovic. Windsor looking to find their way through. Bond intended target headed away by Gonzalez. The back heel flick to Dorenzo, and is this going to be a corner or a goal kick? It looks like it's going to be a goal kick. Get back. Segal. Segal finds its way through. Antoniuk has the overload with Stefanovic, and Stefanovic plays off it. It's ball won back by Darby. Stefanovic, right on target, into the box. Paban, and deflected away by Gonzalez. Agapito, on target, tipped over the net, however. Zekos stands tall. And I mean, all things considered, a well-taken ball there from Jonathan Agapito. And looks like we have a player down for Darby FC. I believe that's Jaden Vilfer. Taking a look at there from athletic therapy, and this will be a substitution will be coming here for Darby. Winter, you know, they're arguing. Let's get this going. And here we go. Cleared out by Pierce. Offside. So we have a substitution officially coming here for Darby. As it's been brewing for a couple minutes, and it will be Krantz Pangop coming on. Segal. Stefanovic in the middle field. Cash is offside. Carrero and a bicycle kick at them. However, Cash once again offside. So substitution now will officially come on as Vilfort's off and Krantz Pangop is on. I want to say this is France's first appearance for Derby on the season. And I don't have this imminently in front of me at the moment. Agapito. Looking in the box for Quiroga. Pierce. Back to Perovic. And we're going to see another substitution. I believe it's Giddy Jimmy. Marcellus Paul also warming up for Darby. Campbell plays it wide. Sikorski gets it in. Potentially a missed hand ball call. Edick. Low shot will skirt wide of the net. So it will be a double substitution as Pierce comes off for Giddy Jimmy. And we'll see Dylan Campbell head off as Marcellus Paul comes on. So an interesting set of substitutions there. Jimmy, more of a defensive anchor in the midfield than Pierce, so it gives them an interesting option there as they look to protect a 2-0 lead here in the 70th minute. Caban is able to turn that into a corner kick, and he is. And offensively, Marcellus Paul has been on fire the past few games. And I mean, he's been a solid contributor throughout the second half of this season, punched away by Zekos. Antonia. Drukalik. There you see the effect of bringing France into the game. France Pengop wins back possession. Windsor able to keep possession. Stefanovic, is he on? And he is, however, this will be a goal kick. Just too strong. So we take into the 72nd minute of play. Darby in full control right now. 2-0. Tasha Collins with his 10th goal of the season off of a penalty kick. Sikorski. And Sikorski pulls up late. We'll see if he's able to stay on. Hang up. Taken down, and Sikorski is still struggling, and he looks like he'll be running back on defense for at the very least, and an aggressive shot taken, and Suko's down.
Physio, just get ready, don't enter the field yet.
Ryan. Suco presents this thing. Good, no trainer. Yeah, that's the kind of fighting spirit that Sukowski has. And, you know, he's, like I said, he started the season injured. So, I mean, he's going to try and play through whatever he can to get as many minutes as possible. But they're going to pull him off to get a look at him. We'll see Paul kind of fill in that spot momentarily for Sukowski as they'll try and figure out the situation with him as he gets the look taken at. Momentarily, Darby will be potentially down a player as they figure that out.
Darby FC substitution in the 74th minute, number 9, Christopher Benavenji enters the match. Exiting the match is number 26, Tyler Sukowski.
So Christopher Benavenji will come on, and Sukowski will head off. Nicely done there by Zekos as he pulls in the save. It was deflected off of somebody's head from a ways out. Took a sharp angle turn. Does well to track it. Cash heads to the ground. And Barbingi's still waiting to get into the game. So Darby still unofficially down a man. Thank God. Ball intended for Agapito. Deflected before he could get there. Jimmy to Paul. He cuts it in. Puts the curling shot on target. And that'll see Barabingi come on to finally fill the hole in the attack for Darby. Barbingi, second leading scorer for Darby on the season. And this will be a drop ball as it hit one of the hanging wires. Collins! Strike and still 2-0, looking for his 11th goal of the season. Potentially another substitution coming for Whitby. Lightly surprised we haven't seen more substitutions coming for Windsor at this stage in the game. Collins, Perovic, Gonzalez. Substitution in the midfield, I would imagine. It looks like it'll be Carlos Edick that comes off. Edick, so solid here today. And really, this midfield and back four have held up well especially when the ball gets played out wide to Stevanovic. You can pretty much count on less than three fingers, I was going to say, on one hand, but hasn't even gotten to the point where he's had five shots. Or even five moments. So they've done well to keep Stevanovic quiet. Ball thrown in. Pabon. And that will be out for a goal kick by Pito. We'll pick up the ball for Zekos. That's a nice one. Ashkin Mohammadi will come on, and Carlos Edick will come off.
Darby FC substitution in the 79th minute, number 15, Ashkin Mohammadi enters the match. Exiting the match is number 47, Carlos Edick.
Agapito, and deflected out off of Giddy Jimmy. So this will be a corner kick coming. Still Windsor looking to find an equalizer and running out of time as we are officially into the 80th minute of play. Antoniuk, well taken. Intended for Riley Drukalik. But Windsor will keep possession. And Windsor desperately looking to find an equalizer, and that certainly will not be it as they give away possession, just gift it to Darby on the sideline. Bingi gets in front of it. It'll be a free kick coming for Windsor. Out by Dorenzo. This will be back for Darby, or for Windsor. Time just starts ticking away, and you can feel the walls close in right now on Windsor. 6-8-1 on the season. Gonzalez clears it out. And this would be Darby's fifth win of the season, should this hold up. Zeko scoops it. Zekos will start taking his time. Ball call going the other way. Windsor now. And headed over. Bingi. So should this result hold, the attention for Darby is going to shift towards Hamilton, who don't play until August 1st. when they take on Guelph United at the Centennial Bowl in Guelph. But it's an interesting timing here at the end of the season. Hamilton has been up and down. Cross in from Ash. Oh, and just wide of the net. Casher Collins looking to add another to this total. But Hamilton's been up and down and kind of streaky throughout the back end of the season. Had a winless stretch of four games, including three losses. On the back end of that, 1-0 win against Masters, an 8-1 win against BBBIA Waterloo, a 3-1 win at Blue Devils FC, which is a wonderful result. Cross in. Pangop will lose possession as Antonio gets there just slightly before him. And then finally, a 2-1 or a 2-0 win over Pro Stars in their final match. So this whole thing could come down to which Hamilton are you going to get in the final games. And again, Darby will have to pick up nearly every point available in the meantime. We have a player down for Windsor, although looks like they'll be back up. It's Pabon. Giddy Jimmy. To Ashcon. The back end of the season for Hamilton also packed with some very talented teams. Kasha to Jimmy. They'll play it back to Paul, playing a bit out of position right now at the left back role. And Quiroga. He'll move it forward on the attack. Agapito, back to Quiroga. Aguilera. Aguilera looking for Pabon, and he's sealed off by Julian Gonzalez, who has played just wonderful here tonight. Collins on the run. That will go back to Thomas. Stefanovic runs into Paul. Pabon has some room to get a shot off. He does and sends it wide. So as we look at the back end of the schedule for Hamilton, Burlington, Guelph on the road, Alliance United FC, Scorsopi FC, and Woodbridge Striker. And there is some real talent on those teams. And I'm not going to say that Hamilton's going to lose all of them. Certainly don't believe that Hamilton will win all of them. So it'll be an interesting final stretch of the season. Zykos picks it up. 87 minutes. The time crunch is real right now. Windsor feels like they have just ran out of steam here down the stretch. And it's been a great performance from Darby. Jimmy gives it out wide to Kasha. It's an interesting formation there from Darby, where they had like four people up on the attack. So Ash moves up. Cash flips sides with Badabingi. And then you have Marcellus Paul, who's playing left back right now. He moves up Nonetheless, this will be a free kick from Colin Riley, one of the goal scorers here on the evening, and arguably one of the goals of the weekend for League One Ontario. Just a beautiful strike. And Carrero, unable to grasp it out of the air, knocks it down. I'm surprised that that's Windsor ball. Agapito. Stefanovic. He plays it back to Aguilera. Aguilera will move it out wide, and Windsor has to do something on one of their next attacks, or this is going to get extremely difficult for them. And it's getting to that situation already, and sealed off. Oshkon is moving today. Jimmy. Back to Betabingi. France Pangop. Had a few good moments on the ball here today. And added time, 4 minutes, the minimum. Officially into added time now. 4 minutes, I mean, you can certainly do something in 4 minutes. We've seen stretches of back-to-back goals that have come within 3 minutes, would come within 2 minutes. They can come fast and furious in the dome here. Certainly Windsor is happy to be inside of the dome here today, as it was just maybe not a torrential downpour, but a consistent downpour throughout the morning. Pangop, he's got some room. Trying to find Betabingi. Can he get there? Betabingi collides with Carrero, who is well off his line moving up right now. I mean, who are you even looking for there? Carrero is trying to explain himself to his teammates. Zekos. Cash. Out to Paul. Gonzalez. And out of bounds. So after this game, Darby will head on the road Saturday, August 5th, when they head to the Paramount Fine Food Center to take on Sigma FC. And then they'll return back here for what is likely a potentially make or break game if they get some luck from Hamilton. As they will take on Simcoe County, one of the teams that has clinched their spot here in the premiership for the next season. 92 minutes has elapsed, about 2 minutes left here in added time. And Jimmy, in a loud collision. So Sagal gets a admonishment and some instructions from the referee. The referee says, look, I don't want to give you a yellow, but this is what you got to do to prevent that from next time. Betabingi, he turns the corner. Ashcon right on top of it, unable to finish. And a sliding tackle from Michael DiRenzo. Windsor. And time is just ticking away. And the body language from Windsor is telling the story right now. Darby has really played a good game here today. They've earned this victory. Two set piece goals. Have come close on multiple occasions of just getting goals through natural buildup alone. But beyond that, they've been solid defensively, solid in the midfield. And all of the substitutions that have come on have played played their role. And there you have it. A 2-0 victory for Darby FC. And that's their second win in a row. Thank you for joining us here today. I've been Sean McLeod, and we'll see you next time.